Given unto us, Father, we are gathering as it is written, where two or three are gathered in my name, I'm in their presence. You know all our needs. We just surrender everything unto thee. In Jesus Christ's holy name, we have prayed. Amen. We are gonna read from the Bible because the Bible is the Word of God, and we know God has given us His Word, especially at this evening time, because we know that we are at the end of the end. The Lord Jesus Christ is coming. Now, as we are preparing for the return of our Lord Jesus Christ, the devil is also fighting fiercely against us. As children of God, we must be ready. And the good thing that we have is the Word of God. We shall go through some scriptures today. You know, when we read in the book of Isaiah chapter 43, the Bible says in the book of Isaiah chapter 43, from verse 1, the Bible says, "But now, thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I've redeemed thee, I've called thee by thy name, thou art mine." So if the Lord could tell us, fear not, he knew that something that could be against us will be on our way.
Amen.
And then he continues with verse 2. "When thou passeth through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior." Can you imagine? He says, "I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee. Since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and have loved thee. Therefore will I give men for thee and people for thy life." He repeats again, "Fear not, for I'm with thee. I will bring thy seed from the east and gather thee from the west." These are wonderful words from our Lord. He's saying, he is assuring us again that if he is with us.
Amen. Yeah, amen.
And something that the Lord God will never say is, "I have failed." No, he has never failed. He will never fail. He has never, you know, disappointed anyone. So in this end time, I know all over the earth, brothers and sisters who are expecting the return of the Lord, who are preparing themselves for the return of the Lord, don't expect easy life. Because the devil knows that his days are numbered. So he will hit. He will hit. Not lightly, it is gonna hit very hard. And what the devil is trying to achieve is to bring down many children of God, to bring them down, to bring their faith down, to decrease their faith. And you remember, according to Hebrews chapter 11, faith is the substance of sin that of things that are unseen. And no one can please God without faith.
Amen.
Without faith, no one can please God.
Amen.
The devil is trying to discourage as many as possible to bring our faith down in such a way that you say, no, but, you know, I'm going through this, I'm going through that, why God is forsaking me. When we read again the book of Psalms, you know, by God's grace, we are going to try to exhort, encourage one another. Because I know time has come for us to remain strong in the Lord. We must be sure that the Lord God is with us. Because if he's not with us, then we are useless. Then we are worthless. There is only one who defeated the enemy, and that is our Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
None of us, by our thinking or by our intelligence or by school or whatsoever, we can defeat him. It's only the one who defeated him. That's the one that we need now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, in the book of Psalms chapter 46, the Bible says, you know, I love the word of God because the word of God is God himself. The more you trust him, the more he's with you, and then he will make you strong. Psalms chapter 46, verse 1. From verse 1, the Bible says, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble.
Amen.
When we are in trouble, we might think that we are alone. No, we are not alone. He is with us and is our strength, is our refuge. Listen, verse 2. Therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed, and though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, Selah. You know, when you see Selah in the Bible, it tells us to stop and think about what we have read. Now, when you continue, there is a river, the stream whereof shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacle of the Most High. Oh my, oh my, oh my. I like it. Listen. Here, the Bible says, maybe let me jump again. Yes, I'm going to read. No, no, verse 5. Yes. God is in the midst of her. She shall not be moved. God shall help her, and that right early. The heathen rage, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice. The earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us.
Amen.
No wonder, you know, when you have the time to go to Israel, and you see how the Jews, the way, their attitude, they know that they are surrounded by enemies, but I've never seen people so confident like Jews. Because they know the Lord God is with them. And that is what it is in them. They know that, you know, all these Palestinians, whosoever, they can do whatsoever they wish to, but they know that they will never be forsaken by God.
Mm-hmm.
When we continue verse 10, the Bible says, Be still and know that I am God.
Amen.
You know, when the Lord wants us to be still, He wants us to be quiet. Oh, yes, there is a scripture that I would like to read also in Isaiah. Yes, yes, let us go back to the book of Isaiah. Isaiah, just after Proverbs, Isaiah chapter 30. I like this scripture. Isaiah chapter 30. Today we will encourage one another. Time is really, I can say it's very, very difficult for many Christians. The devil knows that any time from now the rapture must take place and the two children of God will be raptured. When we read Isaiah chapter 30, verse 15, 1-5, the Bible says, "For thus saith the Lord God, the Holy One of Israel, in returning and rest shall ye be saved, in quietness and in confidence shall be your strength."
Praise God.
Amen. Can you imagine? I can still, you know, when, you know, I can still recall when we were in Israel. We were standing in front of the Red Sea. When you look at the size of the Red Sea, and many, many years ago, many, many years ago, the children of Israel walked, they crossed the Red Sea on a dry land. Can you imagine? Behind them, the Egyptians were following them because they said, "No, these people now, they are finished." People were crying, and then the Lord told Moses, "Why are you crying?" And that's the situation of many of us. When we are in a desperate condition, we start crying. But the Lord told Moses, "Don't cry. Speak to the children of Israel." And then he said, "But use that stick and just hit the waters and you will see what will happen." The Bible says, when it is describing how they were crossing, it was on dry land. So the waters on the right side became a wall, the left side also. So they crossed. I can imagine the fishes, when they could come, they say, "What is happening?" But God make a miracle. And Moses was confident because he knew that he belonged to God and God was using him. The same applies also with the children of God today. When the problem arises, we must look unto Jesus, as the Bible says, the author and finisher of our faith. We must go back to him. We must go back to him. You know, when we read in the book of Isaiah, yeah, today we shall read a lot of Isaiah and use this one. In the book of Isaiah, let me show it to you. Put it here.
As I was trying to do, you put it somewhere, yeah. Just yeah.
When we read in the book of Isaiah, chapter 12, oh my, listen what the Bible is saying. Isaiah chapter 12, the Bible says, verse 2, behold, God is my salvation. Yes, brother. Isaiah, it must be somewhere here. Yes.
Sorry.
Isaiah chapter 12. Yes, we shall read it from there. Yes.
In I'll the just book. Go back.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, yeah.
Yes, Isaiah chapter 12. Mm-hmm. When we read verse 2, the Bible says, behold, you know, when we see behold, God is not led to have our attention. Behold, God is my salvation. I will trust and not be afraid. For the Lord Jehovah is my strength and my song. He also is become my salvation. You know, as we read initially, is our refuge, is our strength. Now we are reading the very same God is our salvation. So when we are in trouble, when we see that we are about to perish, we need someone who is our salvation, and that one is God Himself. I like it.
Yeah.
I like it. And when we, the same book of Isaiah, because we are still there, we can go to the book of Isaiah chapter 14. Yes. Isaiah chapter 14. When we read verse 24, listen. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 24, the Bible says, the Lord of hosts had sworn, saying, surely, as I have thought, so shall it come to pass, and as I have purposed, so shall it stand. So the Lord God, when He called us, He never called us to lose us, no. When He called us, because He had a purpose with us. And no one can stop Him. You know, sometimes when we are trying to convince, to share, to exhort some brothers and sisters, I always say, we must trust God. We must believe Him. Our unbelief will never stop God. Because there is something that the Lord decided to do. Even our God, He decided to do. No one will stop Him. And then when we continue, listen what the Bible says, verse 26. This is the purpose that is purposed upon the whole earth. And this is the hand that is stretched out upon all the nations. Verse 27. For the Lord of hosts had purposed, and who shall disannul it? And His hand is stretched out, and who shall turn it back? No one. That's why, you know, if there is something that I will suggest to everyone is to become a child of God. Because when you are a child of God, you are sure that your heavenly Father is looking after you. Everyone can forsake you. You can even see that your neighbors, your colleagues, your brothers, sisters are mocking you, but the Heavenly Father, that's why, you know, He's a Father.
Yeah.
And the father is the one who takes care of his sons, daughters, even his wife. Yeah. And is a responsible father. And that's the one that we are preaching today. And that's the one that we would like each one of us to trust him, to believe him, and to wait upon him. Listen, Isaiah chapter 45, the same book of Isaiah, when we go, Isaiah chapter 45, I would like to read it. Isaiah chapter 45, listen to what he's saying, verse 5. I am the Lord, and there is none else. There is no God besides me. Amen. I gather thee, though thou hast not known me, that they may know from the rising of the sun and from the west, that there is none besides me. I am the Lord, and there is none else. Listen. I form the light and create darkness. I make peace and create evil. I, the Lord, do all these things. Now, when we jump, we go to the same book of Isaiah. Isaiah 45. Yes. I like it. Verse 18. For thus saith the Lord that created the heavens, God himself that formed the earth and made it, he had established it, he created it not in vain. He formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord, and there is none else. Now listen, verse 19. I have not spoken in secret. In a dark place of the earth, I said not unto the seed of Jacob, seek ye me in vain. Can you imagine it? I, the Lord, speak righteousness. I declare things that are right. Now, when we look, verse 22, now listen. The one who created everything, the same Isaiah chapter 45. Now, when we go verse 22, can you imagine, you know, the God himself, the one who created everything. Now listen what he's saying. Verse 22. Look unto me and be saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God and there is none else. I have sown by myself the word, what we are reading now. The word is gone out of my mouth in righteousness and shall not return that unto me. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall swear. You know, when you read in Philippians chapter 2, verse 10, the Bible says everyone must bow down in front of Jesus. So, the Jehovah of the Old Testament is Jesus in the New Testament, because he became a man, walked here because he wanted to save us. I like it. You know, when the same book of Isaiah, today we are encouraging one another. The devil doesn't like us, but we must keep on trusting our Lord. The same book of Isaiah, now chapter 58. Listen what the Bible is saying. When you have time, you can read it, but because of time, I'm just reading this. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 9. The Bible says, verse 9. Then shall thou call, and the Lord shall answer. Thou shalt cry, and he shall say, here I am.
Amen.
Yeah. Praise God.
That can only happen to the children of God. No, we are parents. You know, who is that parent when a child is crying, then he will just ignore him? No. But the one who created us, the one who says, I'm the only God, is telling us this morning, look unto me. Cry, I will answer.
Yes.
It's like what we read in the book of Jeremiah. There is a scripture that just next chapter. Yeah.
Yes.
Jeremiah chapter 33. I like it. I always read it for brethren.
Yeah.
In the book of Isaiah, Jeremiah chapter 33. Listen what the Bible says from verse 2. Jeremiah 33. Jeremiah 3:3. Jeremiah 33.
Oh, 30, sorry.
Yeah, 33.
Yeah.
From verse 2. Listen what the Bible is saying. Thus saith the Lord, thy maker. Yeah, 33. Let me, yes. Jeremiah 33, from verse 2. The Bible says, thus saith the Lord, the maker thereof, the Lord that formed it, to establish it, the Lord is his name. Amen. Now listen, verse 3. Call unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not.
Yeah, praise God.
And the one who is saying, call unto me, is not a liar.
No.
When he gives promises, he must fulfill it. As it is written in the book of Philippians chapter, the Philippians chapter 1 verse 6, the one who started the good work in you must perform it. And as we read also in Jeremiah, when my word comes, it shouldn't come back to me in vain. It must produce the fruit. And that's why this morning I'm glad to be one of the children of God.
Yeah, praise God.
Yes, brother. Because when you are a child of God, you know, I remember some few weeks ago I was telling to my family, I say, you know, when you are a child of God, you might be found somewhere and you see a lion coming. The one who created that lion can come also and do exactly what he did with, Daniel. He can stop that lion. So when a danger is coming, call upon him.
Yes.
Call upon him and he will answer. That's our God. There is only one tomb which is empty. We went to Israel several times. Each time when we are in Jerusalem, when we are entering the empty tomb of Jesus, I say, yes, he is not here. The Lord Jesus Christ is alive.
Amen.
He is alive. The entire world has forsaken him. No one wants the Lord Jesus Christ. Can you imagine? You follow the government fighting to solve this, to solve that. They have a lot of solutions, earthly solution, of course, but
no answers.
They try this, they try that, but they can't manage to solve the problems.
True.
The solution for the entire humanity is the Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You teach your son, your daughter, everyone to respect the Lord Jesus Christ, to believe him, to follow him, to do everything, the entire world will be at peace. No one will kill another one.
Praise God. That's right.
Yes. When a child comes for rehabilitation because he has been smoking or drinking and whatsoever, after some few days or months, he will relapse. But when he receives Jesus Christ, when he has got what we call the new birth, as the Lord Jesus Christ described in John chapter 3 from verse 3 to 6, you go down. When someone is born again, to be born again, it means the Lord Jesus Christ comes in someone's life, he stops his life and starts his life, I mean the life of Jesus Christ in that person, and then that's the new birth. The entire world is looking for solution left and right, but they can't find it because they have forsaken Jesus. Yet this is the solution to all our problems. You know, brethren, when we read in the book, the same, because we are in Jeremiah chapter 17 now. Yes. Jeremiah chapter 17, the Bible says, oh, I love the Bible. Jeremiah chapter 17, when we read from verse 7, yes. Listen what the Bible says. Blessed is the man that trusteth in the Lord, and whose hope the Lord is.
Oh, praise Lord.
I know many governments here on earth trust in their constitutions and whatsoever, but no one put his trust in the Lord. No one. Our hope is the Lord himself. And when we continue verse 8, listen, this should apply to everyone that puts his trust in the Lord. For he shall be as a tree, hallelujah, planted by the waters, and that spreadeth out roots by the river, and shall not see when he cometh. But our leaf shall be green and shall not be careful in the year of drought, neither shall cease from yielding fruit. Now listen, verse 9. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? Now listen, verse 10. I, the Lord, search the heart. I try the reins, even to give every man according to his ways and according to the fruit of his doings.
Yes, praise God. Thank you, Lord.
Oh, my.
Thank you.
You know, my brothers, sisters, I know you are following us all over the world. There is another scripture here in Jeremiah chapter 29, because we are in the book of Jeremiah. Now, Jeremiah chapter 29. We must know one thing. There is nothing impossible unto God.
Amen.
Nothing is impossible unto him. And he has never changed. The same yesterday, today, and forever. I always say, listen, brethren. Jeremiah is no more here. David is no more here. Solomon is no more here. James is no more here. Peter is not here. All the disciples of Jesus Christ, they are no more here. But there must be people here on earth that must be used exactly the same way John was used, Peter was used, James was used. And those people are the ones that believe and trust the Lord, because he has never changed. When we read Jeremiah chapter 29, listen what the Bible says from verse 11. Jeremiah 29 from verse 11, the Bible says, "For I know the thought that I think toward you, saith the Lord."
Amen.
Listen, thought of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end.
Amen.
These words must be fulfilled to the children of God.
Mm-hmm.
So the Creator, what a privilege. The Creator has got good thoughts towards me.
Mm-hmm.
And that then those thoughts are the thoughts of peace.
Mm-hmm.
And those thoughts is to give unto me an expected end. Then listen to verse 12. "Then shall he call upon me, and he shall go and pray unto me, and I will hearken unto you, and he shall seek me," listen, "and find me, when he shall search for me with all your hearts." Verse 14. "And I will be found of you, saith the Lord." This is not a man speaking. It is the Lord himself, the Creator. I like it. He spoke and the earth was formed. He spoke, light was separated from darkness.
Mm-hmm.
He spoke, we had trees. He spoke, you know, everything that is around us came not by reasoning. He didn't reason. He spoke. And when he was speaking, he knew that as I'm speaking, it will come to pass.
Yes, praise God.
And to him, there is nothing, nothing, nothing that is impossible.
Yes.
Oh, is the God that we are preaching today.
Yes.
And that is the God that can say unto us, oh yes, because we are still in Jeremiah. Now, Jeremiah chapter 32. Jeremiah chapter 32. Yes, I found the scripture. Jeremiah chapter 32. Listen what the Bible is saying. Oh my. First of all, I will read verse 17. Listen. "Ah, Lord God, behold, thou hast made the heaven and the earth by thy great power, and stretched out arm, and there is nothing to add for thee." Hallelujah. And then he continues now. Listen. Verse 26. I like it. If you have time, you can read everything. But because of time, verse 26. "Then came the word of the Lord unto Jeremiah, saying," you know, verse 17, he was praying. You know? Verse 17, he was praying. Now, 26, "Then came the word of the Lord unto Jeremiah, saying, Behold, I am the Lord, the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me?" And then, those same words, when we come to the New Testament, I would like us to go there in the book of Mark chapter 10. Listen. Mark chapter 10. Yes, in the New Testament. After, yes, let's find it somewhere here. Mark and after Matthew, yes.
Yeah.
After Matthew, we find, Mark chapter 10. The Bible is saying, You remember what happened, you know, the Lord Jesus Christ was speaking, Mark chapter 10, verse 23. Listen to what the Bible says. Jesus said unto him, If thou can believe, all things are possible to him that believeth. Just to believe, and everything will be possible unto us. The same way when we read in the book of Luke, just after Mark, Luke chapter 1. Luke chapter 1, verse 37. 3:7, Luke chapter 1, verse 37. For with God, nothing shall be impossible. And that is the God that we would like today to trust, and to trust more and more and more and more. And that God, his name is our Lord Jesus Christ. Mm-hmm. The Bible says in the book of 1 John, yes, let me read it. 1 John chapter 5, just before Revelation day. 1 John chapter 5. Listen to what the Bible says, verse 20. And we know, 1 John chapter 5, verse 20, yes. Yeah. And we know that the Son of God is come and had given us an understanding that we may know him that is true, and we are in him that is true, even in his Son Jesus Christ. Listen to what the Bible says. This is the true God and eternal life.
Amen.
This Jesus is the true God and eternal life. That's why the Bible says, receive Jesus Christ. Receive Jesus Christ. Receive Jesus Christ. That's why he's saying in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 14 to 18. Come out of them, because there is so much confusion now all over the earth. Denominations. When you see what is happening in the so-called churches of God, no one refers to the Bible. Everyone is talking about their own programs, whatsoever. You will see preachers mentioning things which, you know, they are going there for jokes. Can you imagine? People leave their houses to go to church, and the preacher standing there is mentioning jokes. This is a serious time for each one of us to be prepared. Because he said in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 14 to 18, I will dwell in you. I will walk in you. So we, being the children of God, we must be ready to receive Jesus Christ in us. And then when the Lord Jesus Christ dwelleth in us, not a single devil will dare to touch us. Because before the devil touches you, he must first defeat Jesus Christ. Because Jesus Christ, you know, the devil can come, fight against you. You just call upon the Lord Jesus Christ. The devil will flee. The devil will flee. That's why today, as I was mentioning in the beginning, the devil is fighting. You will see from time to time, people will say, but you know, I'm trying to do this, I'm trying to do that. Things are very difficult. Yes. The devil cannot fight against his own children. No wonder you see many people, they prosper. money-wise, you know, whatsoever. But they are in esoteric movements. They are Satanists. They are, you know, and the devil cannot fight them because they belong to him.
That's right.
But the children of God who stay with the word of God, the devil will do everything to fight against us day and night. If the devil doesn't fight against you, you are his best friend. You are walking together. But for us, as the Bible says in the book of Ephesians chapter 6, the Bible speaks clearly in the book of Ephesians chapter 6 from verse 10. The Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord. Not to be strong in the church, not to be strong, you know, in your denomination, not to be strong with muscles, you know, you go for gym and then you have a lot of muscles. No, it's our strength is in the Lord and in the power of his mighty. Put on, listen, what the Bible is telling us. I'm telling you, this is the final battle that we are going through.
It's true.
Now, the Bible says, put on the whole armor of God. Why? That ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil.
Amen.
Verse 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood. You know, I like why the Bible is putting wrestling here. Wrestling is a tough game. Eh? I don't like it, you know. So it is a tough game, you know, when wrestlers are fighting, if he can get hold of, you know,
struggle.
Yeah, struggle, you know, if he gets his enemy, he will make sure that that man is finished. Now the Bible says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, not one, many. Against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. So the battle is really serious one. So if you're not strong, you'll be defeated. But our strength is in the Lord. And then the Bible continues verse 13. Wherefore, hallelujah, take unto you the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to withstand in the evil day. We are in the evil day. And having done all, to stand. Many today, even Christians, cannot stand. Why? Because they forget to remain in the Lord. When you are no more in the Lord, you will fall. You can't stand. If some of us can stand, it's because we are in the Lord. And then the Bible continues verse 14. Stand therefore, having, listen, your loins girt about with truth. You know, no wonder the Lord Jesus Christ said, you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free.
Praise God.
Now the devil is taking the truth far away from many people. The Bible says, verse 14, I will read it again. Stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness. Listen. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. above all, hallelujah, above all, taking the shield of faith. No wonder the disciples could tell the Lord Jesus Christ, increase our faith. Increase our faith. Because without faith, no one can please God. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit. Listen, what is the sword of the Spirit? Which is the word of God.
Amen.
So the sword of the Holy Spirit is this one, the Bible, the word of God. That's why the devil is taking from the children of God the word of God. Because the word of God, which we are reading here, is the sword of the Spirit. With the sword of the Spirit, God, you know, can cut in pieces our enemy. Oh my, now verse 18. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance. We must be perseverant. Perseverant. And supplication for all saints. Praise yes, God. My precious brothers, maybe before we close, I will go in the Old Testament, in the book of 2 Chronicles. Yeah. 2 Chronicles. It should be just after Kings. Somewhere here. Yeah, after Kings, yes. 2 Chronicles. In the book of 2 Chronicles, chapter 20. Second Chronicles chapter 20. You know, as before we read the scripture, our God, even our Lord Jesus Christ, knows everything. He knows everything that's happening in our lives. When we read verse 14, the Bible says, and he said, hearken ye, all Judah, and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, and thou King Jehoshaphat, thus saith the Lord unto you, be not afraid, nor dismayed by reason of this great multitude. For the battle is not yours, but God's. Hallelujah.
Praise you, Jesus.
Amen. That's why I always say, it's like we are now here in this compound. If anyone wants to come and fight my son, he will meet me. Yes. If anyone wants to come and fight my wife in my yard, he will meet me. The same applies with us. We are in the kingdom of God. Anyone who wants to come and fight against us, he will meet God. And our God has never failed. So whosoever who wants to fight against the children of God is already a failure. Because I've never seen in the Bible a single battle that God has lost. Never.
Praise God.
That's why, as children of God, we are really at the end of the end time. The enemy knows that he doesn't have time anymore. He will do everything. Everything to make the children of God to disbelieve the Bible, to see their faith going down, to doubt their God, to remove their trust, you know, towards God, He will do everything. Some may even lose job just because the devil wants to see their faith going down. But as for us, as I always say, I and my house, we must serve the Lord.
Amen.
Because we know when we are in the Lord, even if there are waves, you know, coming from left, right, from front, from behind, it will be as, you know, when we were on the Sea of Galilee. I remember we were on the boat, and then our precious brother Frank was preaching that day, and then said, yes, it was exactly like this many, many years ago, more or less more than 2,000 years ago, when the waves were coming from left and right. The disciples never jumped out of the ship. They went and awaken the Lord Jesus Christ and say, we are perish, we are perish. So for us children of God, we are in the boat where our Lord himself is the captain. Now when the waves are coming, we shouldn't be afraid. We shall just go and say, Lord, these are my troubles, these are my problems, these are ABCD. And himself, you know, when he speaks, he's still the creator. He can stop anything, he can create anything, you know, he does everything according to the good will of his heart. You know, for us Christians, we must also follow the ABC. ABC for us Christian, A stands for always, B stands for believe, C stands for Christ. We must always believe Christ. Even if we see that we are dying, we are sinking, we must always believe Christ. And when he comes in, if there was darkness, darkness will be changed to light. If there was sorrow, sorrow will turn to joy. If there was, you know, troubles, you know, he will come and change, make peace. That's our God. Yes. So we shall pray, and for those who are online, you can also pray, but as for us, let us pray, let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, once more we believe thy word. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Father, all these scriptures are for our good. You know exactly the conditions of each one of us, the kind of problems that we are facing. Father, if we were behaving like unbelievers, we come back to you under the precious blood which was shed on the cross of Calvary, and ask for forgiveness. May that precious blood which was shed on the cross cleanses us all, so that we can become whiter than snow. Father, we are calling upon thee, as you said in Jeremiah chapter 33, verse 3, that we have to call upon thee. Father, you know the conditions of many brothers and sisters who are like desperate, but you are our solution. If we don't come to you, to whom shall we go? Oh, Heavenly Father, you are the words of eternal life. Thank you, precious Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, because we know, as you said, you have gone to prepare for us a place, as it is written in John chapter 14 from verse 1 to 3. Oh, Heavenly Father, come and fetch us back home so that we can be with you there forever. Heavenly Father, destroy whatsoever the enemy is trying to do in my brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ's name. Oh, Heavenly Father, you never failed. You will never fail. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Thank you. Thank you for receiving our prayers. In Jesus Christ's name, we have prayed. Amen. Stop it. God bless you.
Amen.
Bless you.